This is 4-57 from RC Hibbeler Engineering Statics 12 edition. According to this problem, we have to determine the magnitude of the moment produced by the force F about the y-axis, and we have to use scalar as well as Cartesian vector approach. To solve this problem, first of all, we have to resolve this force, which is 16 newtons. So this force has one component parallel to the x-axis and one component parallel to the z-axis, like this. Let's label them. This is 16 sine 30. This component is 16 cos 30. Now we have resolved our force in its components. Now we have to resolve the moment arm. The moment arm is taken from point O to point B. So this is our moment arm. Now we also have to resolve this moment arm. This moment arm has two components, one parallel to the x-axis and another one parallel to the z-axis. This component is, this is in millimeters, so we will convert it into meters. So it is 0.2 sine 45 degrees, and this component is 0.2 cos 45 degrees. Now we have resolved the moment arm and the force into its components. So by using the scalar approach, if I consider moment at O clockwise as positive, then we have this force, which is 16 cos 30, is producing clockwise force, clockwise moment. So we will take it as positive. So it is 16 cos 30, and its moment arm is 0.2 sine 45, perpendicular with the line of action of force. So this is the moment arm for the 16 cos 30 force. Now if you look at this component 16 sine 30, so it is producing counterclockwise movement about this handle. So we have to take it as negative. Then it is 16 sine 30 into the moment arm is 0.2 cos 45, 0.2 cos 45, this moment arm. Now, moment at point O is equals to 1.9596 minus 1.131. So our answer is 0.828 newton meter. This is our answer by the scalar approach. Now we have to get the same answer with the Cartesian vector approach. So if I remove all this, so to solve by Cartesian vector approach, we need coordinates. By using Cartesian vector approach, again we have to resolve this force. So this force has two components, This is 16 sine 30, and this component is 16 cos 30. So the force vector can be written as negative 16 cos 30 I plus 16 sine 30 k. Negative is because it is directed in the negative sense of positive x-axis. From here, our force vector F is negative 13.85 I plus 8k. So we have resolved the force F into Cartesian vector form. Now we have to find the moment arm. So our moment arm is between point O and point B. So we have to find the coordinates. So coordinates of point O are 0, 0, 0 meters, and the coordinates of point B are, now if you look at the figure, then if I consider this vector, then I can resolve it into two components. This is 0.2 cos 45 and this is 0.2 sine 45. So the x component of point B is 0.2 cos 45 comma, there is no y component, but there is z component, which is 0.2 sine 45. So it is 0.2 sine 45, and it is negative because it is going downwards. So we can also write point B as 0.1414 I comma 0 comma negative 0.1414. So now we have to find the moment arm ROB. It is equals to coordinates of point B minus coordinates of point O. So it is 0.1414 I plus 0j minus 0.1414 k. Now to find the moment. Moment at O is equals to the determinant. I J K and the moment arm, which is 0.1414 negative 0.1414. Similarly, the force F, which is negative 13.85 08. From here I is equals to 0 0, negative 0.1414 8 minus J 0.1414 negative 13.85 negative 1414 8 plus 0.1414 00 negative 13.85. So if you solve this, then this term is 0, this term is also 0. We have negative J 0.1414 into 8 minus negative 0.1414 into negative 13.85. So the J component is approximately 0.828 Newton meter. This is the answer to this problem. I hope you will find this video helpful. If you do, please don't forget to subscribe this channel and also turn on the bell icon for the daily updates. And if you have any question about this problem, then you can ask them in the comment section. And I already have uploaded the solutions of chapter 2, chapter 3 and chapter 4 from the same book, so you can also check them out. Thank you.